How to cure waswas and ghusl, the OCD in bathing. When you want to make ghusl or ritual bath, are you caught up with clouds of doubts about your ghusl routine? Are you stuck in a cycle of doubt, overwashing, and wasting water? Fear not! We've got the ultimate guide to transform your ghusl experience from a doubtful maze to a simple, pleasant ritual. We'll unravel practical steps to conquer doubts, wipe away excessive worries, and reclaim control over your cleansing journey. Stay tuned for a shower of insights, empowering you to bid farewell to waswas and embrace the tranquility of ghusl like never before. Here you are in the bathroom, ready for your ghusl. Instead of a normal, easy experience, doubts start to swirl in your mind about your intention might be invalid or that you unintentionally intended something else. The fear of missing a body part or wasting water lingers. In many cases, the doubts arise while washing your underarms or navel, insisting on overwashing due to doubts. And Shaitan convinces you that your hair, ears, limbs, or everything are not wet enough. The result? Hours spent overwashing, rubbing your skin red in the pursuit of perfection. Let us begin. Breaking the cycle. As we have explained in the previous video about waswas and wudhu, many of you suffer from waswas and niyyah intention. Allah knows what you are going through, and He, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, does not intend a burden for you. When it comes to Shaitan, he will try to make you feel guilty and neglectful in your worship, which can lead to different forms of intrusive thoughts. He acts like a burden on your shoulders and tries to control you through doubt, which is one of his main tactics. So always keep in mind, doubts have no effect on your ghusl or niyyah. You can doubt, but these doubts have no value. Allah's command is to form the intention. How do you form intention? Intention is the thought or feeling that arises even before conscious thought. It is a spontaneous action of the heart, like a goal or a cause for something to occur. You possess the intention prior to contemplating it. Every action stems from an intention. Therefore, if you rise to perform ghusl, there is no necessity to intend again, since every action requires an intention and a purpose. Just ask yourself, what am I doing? If you know what you are doing, then you already had the intention established and you do not repeat making an act of repetition as Shaitan advises. Allowing the doubt to exist without giving in interrupts the cycle of obsessive thoughts. This is a crucial step in reclaiming control. If you find yourself caught in a loop of negative thoughts, take a moment to pause and ask yourself, what is my purpose here? This simple question can help break the cycle of repetitive, unproductive thinking. By acknowledging your intentions and refusing to give in to doubt, you can take back control of your thoughts and actions. Remember, reclaiming control is a process and it starts with interrupting the cycle of obsessive thoughts. It is up to you which ghusl you wish to follow. The minimum action. Fard, obligatory one, making sure everything is wet once. Or with the sunnahs. If you choose to perform the ghusl with the sunnahs, it is recommended to begin by washing the hands and private parts, then performing wudu as you would for prayer. After that, pour water over your head 3 times, making sure it reaches the roots of your hair, and then wash the rest of your body, the right part followed by the left. This is the preferred way to perform ghusl according to the sunnah. But if you suffer from waswas al-qari, the overwhelming waswas, some scholars advise to keep it as simple as possible until you get more accustomed to the doubts or can ignore them. Because they say the more complex an action is, the more chances for waswas, waste of water and time. Once you have performed your niyyah, intention, once, say Bismillah once as you are able to in that moment, dispelling doubts about your intentions. Frightened doubts do not invalidate your actions, so just go on. Keep your focus on your intention and trust that your actions are sincere. Remember that Allah is all-knowing and all-merciful, and He sees the purity of your heart. So, proceed with confidence and trust in your intentions. Ghusl or wudu frights and doubts have no base in reality. They are a mere mind game of Shaitan manipulating your OCD loop. Ghusl and wudu are simply acts of purification and cleanliness in Islam, and there is no need to let doubts or fears cloud your mind. Shaitan preys on these insecurities to create unnecessary anxiety and stress. Remember to focus on the true purpose of these rituals and trust in the guidance of Allah. You might think, what if I intended something else meanwhile? An intention is something sure and not something trivial. Doubts have no value. If you would have intended something else, you wouldn't doubt it. Remember from cognitive restructuring in the previous video that intentions are strong. This doubt is just another game of shaitan to make you confused. Pour water once over your entire body, just like a regular rinse. Wet your hair, ears, neck, back. There is no need to rub your body parts other than the scalp. Just make sure they are wet. Now, with your slightly damp hands, reach for any body parts that may remain dry. You may just simply wipe with your hands over all your body with the water already present on your skin. Remember, pouring water over your head will naturally wet your body. No need for excessive rewashing. Continuous ERP application, confronting waswas by the shower. When in doubt during ghusl, choose not to engage. If overwhelmed by waswas, use grounding techniques. Avoid repeating actions or seeking reassurance. Acknowledge that your initial water pour in the shower is enough. Challenge the idea that body parts are not adequately wet. Scholars generally agree in Islamic fiqh that continuity is not essential in ghusl. The majority state that it is not necessary to wash the parts in order and one after the other. If something you washed dried, you do not need to keep it wet. Once that part reached water, you are good to go and continue with the other body parts. Face these triggers head-on, knowing that doubts lose their power when confronted. It's important to acknowledge the doubts and fears that arise, but it's equally important to challenge them. Grounding techniques. Focusing on the present moment. Feel the water on your skin right here, redirecting your attention from obsessive thoughts. Instead of overwashing, visualize a balanced approach. Pour water once, then address any perceived dry spots with the water already available on your skin. Visual therapy, creating mental sanctuaries. Combat anxiety with visual therapy right here in the bathroom. Picture a serene sanctuary, perhaps the bathroom itself, the shower, spa, or a soothing waterfall. Let this mental image serve as a refuge, a place where doubts hold no power. Remember, your ghusl journey is significant, and doubts cannot invalidate its importance. By applying these practical strategies, you regain control over ghusl, eliminating the excessive washing prompted by waswas. No more lingering on the doubts. Confront them with resilience, break free from the cycle of overwashing, and let the water in the shower be a source of purity and peace. Share your thoughts and experiences in the comments. Your journey matters for all of us. Subscribe for more insights, and let's conquer ghusl doubts together. Thank you for being a part of our community.